We use pivot table for analyzing and summarizing of any data. Okay. Let's suppose we have data. So management can ask question about this data that here is a date, name, city and sales. Okay. There are 7 day sales. So management can ask that what is our monthly sale, what is our yearly sale, what is employee wise sale, city wise sale. So these type of queries can be summarized with pivot table. Okay.
Other question, can these pivot tables be seen on real time data?
What, sir?
Oh, can these pivot tables be seen on real-time data, like stock market data, where it's constantly changing?
For that, you need to do refresh all the time for seeing real-time data. If you want some real-time data refresh, because when you apply, there is a refresh button. So if you do with macro, then it can be seen. Real-time refresh also.
Oh, I see. Okay. So this is new VBA.
Yes, yes. So,
okay.
We have this kind of data. Let's see what we can do with it. So, we apply pivot table with insert button. This insert tab. And the same rule applies here. When you press Control A, if the data is selected all, then it means you need not to select the data before applying any pivot table or anything. But if it doesn't, you need to select the data and then go for the option. So in insert tab, we have pivot table. Just click on that. One dialog box is here. Table and range. Okay. So it takes table or a range. Range means named range, which we used last time. There are option new sheet or existing one sheet. We will taking this to new sheet. Okay. So when we go this to new sheet, we can find that the headings are here, listed here. So one thing we need to remember, there should not be any blank heading in the data, because it will not work then. And no merge cell should be there in data. Okay, so we have headers. So we have to take name wise. So we will click on name. There are 4 more columns. So this is for choosing field, and this is report filter, column label, row label and values. So what we do in row label, we just drag the heading name here. So all the names are available here. Now what we want to do, we need to see the sales one. So all the consolidated sale for the person is available here. This is the smallest pivot table. Then we need to see the particular employee is how much they are selling in particular city. So we have city also. For city we can use row or column. But what we need to remember that if our data is too long, unique data is too long to cover in a one sheet. So we can drag, when it is too long, it will be in rows. When it is short, it can be in columns also. So that we can always have a printable format. If the values will be more, it will be difficult to print. So where you have a lot of rows, you just apply there in rows, otherwise in columns you can use. Okay, so we have row wise, employee wise and city wise data here. City is in columns. So we can see that suppose we want to see the Sandeep sales in Palwal city, so it is 1325 Faridabad city. So we have a grand total here of total sales of Sandeep, and we have city wise total also, that total sale of city. Okay.
Yeah.
You can swap the values as well. If you want that, you need to show the city wise report. You pass the city to, just drag it to row labels, name I'm swapping to column labels. So I can see in this format also. The primary name of the report will be decided by the first column, which is name wise report, name wise sales report. Thus, this is city wise sales report. When name was here, name wise sales report. Okay. Now, this dragging dropping is very easy. When you have, you can change the sequence also by city wise. If I keep both in rows, so first it will come and then the name is showing here. When you are in pivot table, you have one option, pivot table tools. In that you have option and design. Two ribbons are extra, you can use with it. So we can customize it. Suppose I want to show, see the city wise data. So we have two options, expand entire field, collapse entire field. So if I collapse entire field, the primary heading will be collapsed and show you only the city wise data. You can expand the column to see the full data. Okay. Then let's work with layout. So in layout in pivot table, we have lot of options. Suppose in compact view, in design, if you go, there are report layout. So currently it is in compact view. Okay. We have two more formats, show outline form, show in tabular view form. So in tabular form, what happens, currently you are seeing in compact view, both headings are coming into one column. When you choose tabular or outline, so the second heading will be in next column. Okay. So it is as per your compatibility. And the subtotal is showing you here in down. So let's suppose you want to create a pivot from a pivot. Means you need to format a data according to you. So with design you can do like this. You don't need this pulval total here. So here is a button subtotal. Okay. So this is called subtotal. If you don't want to see subtotals, so you have, do not show subtotal. So the subtotal will be not shown to you. Then show all subtotal bottom of the group. It was activity, bottom of the group it was shown. Top of the group if you choose, so it is not working actually in compact. It is available in compact view. So if you do it compact, so it is above of the group. Let's see, bottom of the group if we want. So bottom of the group, I clicked in compact view, so you can see the total here. Okay, total. So this is all for subtotals. Do not show subtotals, it will not show you the subtotal. Then grand totals. We have grand total. Let me swap the name here. So grand total column, we have two grand total column. First is this, second is this. Two types of grand total for columns and rows. So if we, let's suppose I don't need for columns, you can on off on-off subtotals from here. So for grand total,
Later on, if you have time, can you show me a demonstration based on the date, like how it's you how you can sort it based on the date?
Yes, I am showing you after this.
Okay, thank you.
So we are getting on and off for grand totals. How to disable for grand totals? We have different options. Off for rows and columns. So we have grand total, two types of grand total, row and column. So you can whatever you want, you can keep it. Like you need this for columns only, or you need for rows only, or you need for both. So you can choose from this report layout, grand totals on four rows and columns. So let's move to I just remove city from here and take the name. Yeah. Okay. Let's add date here. But date I will choose in primary. Okay. So we have date wise total here, but it is no of you because we want monthly, month wise here. So how we do it? It is a feature of grouping. So in option, there is a group field. Okay, just click on that which you want item which you want to group. Suppose date. So you have this group field option. Click on that in option. Okay. Now your starting date and ending date will be available here. So I want to group is month wise. So click on month and press OK. It will be grouped as month. Okay. Let me on that total also, because without total it will not be show you all things subtotals. Okay, so for January we can see this total is there. Okay, now click on that, then go to options, group field. But there is a thing. In these dates you can find January, February, March, April, till December you are finding. Means, but there are lot of years data. So that means when you group month wise, so it grouped month but not the years. All the years are consolidated in, like we are grouping January's data. So every year January data is consolidated here. So what we have to do, we have to group it. Just click on this and group field, month wise and year. Okay, so this month and year we require both two things. So now you can see, if I collapse this field, so there is a year total. When you expand the any year, you can find its month's total. Okay, like this. See, so for every year we have different type of cell. So it's the matter of grouping only. Okay, in group field you can choose, in place of month you can choose quarters also. So for every year, quarter 1, quarter 2, quarter 3, you can see it. Okay, This option is not only for date, it is for time also, so you can group in hours, minutes and seconds also. Okay.
So when I heard there's a pivot table and there's a power pivot. Is that the same?
Power pivot is different from pivot table.
Oh, I see. Okay.
I will explain it to you. Okay. Whatever the data you are creating, let me suppose take out date from there. Whatever data you are creating, you can create the chart immediately from pivot chart. Just click on that. So any type of chart you can create, and whatever changes you do in this pivot table, it will be reflected in your chart also. Okay. So let me make you more clear about pivot tables, because I've just shown you dates and just grouping tricks. The things are more here. Let me have some changes in data. Let's suppose I do it quantity and sales. Let me delete the rest of the data we will generate later on. So we have quantity and sales here. So quantity and sales. Now what I am going to do, I want to create a group like that. First I need to refresh, because I have changed some data there, but there is no changes. So for that, in options we have to refresh the data. Otherwise, right click on pivot table or refresh, or click on that Alt F5. Okay. So we have quantity and sales. Quantity and sales. Now I want to show the quantity as a category. Like I want to consolidate those person who have sold 10 to 20 number quantity, 20 to 30, 30 to 40. Like this, I want to create a group. So how I am going to do? I can use this group field in case of date also, number also. So starting and ending will be here, and how much group you want. 20, 20, 30, 40, whatever. When you choose, you can find the same groups. I have made it for 20. So for 30, 10 to 20, 10 to 29, this was the sales. 30 to 49 quantity, this was the sales. 50 to 69, this was the sales. 70 to 90, this was the sales. So you can group the numbers also. Okay. For ungrouping, you just ungroup from here, ungroup selection. And to clear all type of setting, you have clear all. So you have a default pivot group. Now there are some options. Name, city, and sales. So sometimes we use tabular view in report layout, tabular view. So some people do, they merge this much of column and give a line gap between each group. So how to do in pivot table without doing anything? So we can insert blank rows. Insert blank line after each item. So we have blank line. Okay. And you have option here, right click, pivot table option. This option can be get from option and option, this option, options. So you can, you have this much option also, merge and center cells with the labels. Okay. So this data will be merged like this. Because some people like report like this. So it is my choice, I need blank lines or not. It is my choice, I need total or not, subtotals. So it is a kind of data you can see here, or metadata, okay, in pivot table. You don't want grand total, so you can opt the grand total also. So it will be reflected as data. Okay.
Now are you able to sort the sum of sales from the highest to the lowest?
Yes. Just right click on that and you have sort option, sort largest to smallest. Okay,
thank you.
So you have, according to first group it will be sorted. Okay. That doesn't mean you can sort only, you can change the position of the things also. Like you want Sandeep to be second number, just move it, all data will be moved. Just click on that when you over this line boundary. So this move sign is here and you can drag it to where you want to keep it. Okay. So whole data will be moved. Okay. You can change the position of this tally after Palwal.
Okay.
You can change the position in between also. Okay. So now let's say more about this. Let's review the options we have in pivot table options. These all options actually are here. I have shown to you here, show grand total and show for row and column. Then expand and collapse button. You can see in options there are three buttons. This is field list, you can enable disable from here. This plus buttons you can see, so you can enable disable from here. Okay, field headers, these are the headers, so you can enable disable the headers. Okay. We use some type of formula also there in pivot table. What kind of formula we use? Let us first check out about the values. Let's suppose if we have two type of value, quantity also here. So you can see value, this value field automatically generate in column. So it is a field which shows you these data. Okay. You can drag the position of this value into row also. So you have a different field, sum of sales, sum of quantity. Okay. Let me detach the city from here like this. Earlier it was like this. So you can change the position, change the layout of your report. Okay. As per your requirement.
Just out of curiosity, is it possible to have a pivot table within a pivot table?
What?
Is it possible to have a pivot table within the pivot table?
Within the pivot, no, we can't.
No, can't, okay.
We just copy paste the data and create pivot table again. But
okay.
You can do one thing. Let me just remove that. Like you need pivot, multiple pivots you can have on one sheet. Okay. Let's suppose you have a pivot table, name wise you have shown it. Just copy that, paste it somewhere else. Let me adjust the column. So we have two pivot tables now, here and here. So we can change the settings here. So suppose I need city wise. So here I have city wise, here I have name wise. Somewhere else we can get date wise or monthly, name I remove. Let me just copy paste again. But the grouping we can do only one time. The same grouping will be affected on all pivot tables with the same source of data. So we can choose the view, city I am removing and date I am putting in, and for that I want to create a group option, group field month and year. Collapse. So like this we can show here years. Okay, so we can use different view in pivot table by copying pasting it. Okay. We can keep it on one page. What is its benefit? When you change something there, okay, and when you refresh, you don't have to create all the time these views. If you have created, just refresh, all the changes will be shown updated in these reports, all the reports. Okay. So this refresh work we can do with VBA also. That when we open the sheet, it should be refreshed.
I remember in DB, there's actually a special code just for pivot tables.
Okay, no problem. I will make you expert about pivot tables. So, let us move further because there are lot of things in pivot table. So I was
saying, this is pretty powerful. The pivot table. Oh, sorry, you say?
Yes. So let us talk about report filter. It is a very powerful tool. In report filter, we have entered a city data here. So there is a checkbox we can check like filter, and any city data we can see here. Select multiple items. You can see the multiple data here for two cities. But let's suppose I am working in a company and we have city heads. So we need to send the data to city heads, but the data from their city only. So how we going to do? Let's suppose we have here 7-8 cities, we can do it manually and copy paste. But when we have more than 200-300 cities, it is quite difficult. Okay, like for Palwal city, I will make like this, then send the data to the Palwal city head. Likewise, I have Faridabad city head. I will filter the data and send it to filter. So, how we can do it quickly? So, whatever you have in report report field, you can create separate page for that. You go to option. This is a unique option. So, you have option. And this option also available, then show report filter pages. There is an option show report filter pages. When you click on that, all the report filters fields are, you can see here. So click on that. When you click OK, here there are two sheets only. When you click OK, the separate sheet is created for separate item. Delhi it is Sonipat. Okay, you can see the different type of data and different sheet. Now you can separately send a sheet to the person. Okay, you understood that?
Yeah, I got it.
Let's suppose you need to send the employee-wise report. You can do the same option. Just move employee name to the report field and do it same. So you have created employee-wise report here, and you can send the separate sheet to separate employee. Okay. Let me delete all this. Now, how to format quickly this data? Because we have created 50-60 sheets, but you need to unlink pivot also. Okay, so how we are going to do this? Let's do it again. We show report filter pages city wise, we have generated the data. Okay, so we have generated city wise data. What we can do, we have to just press shift from the first and select the last city. So these all sheets are grouped now. So whatever I will do, it will be affected on all these sheets. So what I am going to do, I'm just selecting the data, Control C, copy, and paste special, paste as values. See, we can find that the pivot table is unlinked now. Now what I need to do, I don't need these columns, let's suppose. From the above, I can delete. But not from the below, because that may be increasing and decreasing. So we can't do it. So we can change the things here only in above part. So like I want here, the items are grouped still. Employee sales report. Type here. Color, bold, whatever type of formatting you want to do, you can do it here. Then let me do it here. So I have created a report. Now just click to any of the sheet or other sheet. Now you can see the format, same format for every file. okay, I have formatted in Chromebook. Why I am doing it from the bottom, you should not do for bottom, because if you do it in cell number 5, so there may be fifth cell number file in a different place. But the above cells will be headings and all will be remain same. Okay, so you can quickly format the data of pivot table. And in VBA there are mailing option also, you can instantly split the data and mail to them. So that's how we do with pivot table, and there are some calculation also. We have sales here. Let me remove report filter. We have sales here. We have two types of formula we use, like group. So in option we have formula tab. First is calculated field. Okay. There are two things, calculated fields and calculated item. So in calculated field, you can create one more field like average. I'm just creating, if you want to see the average, you can see the average from here also. In there are your fields in value, so when you click on that, no need for right to click on that value field setting, so you can choose some count, average, minimum, maximum, but for one time only. So let's suppose you need sum and average also, so you have to create a different field, because one field you can show for one time only, so we need a calculated field. So let's suppose average we require. So in average, what I am going to do, every formula will be started from equal to, then here is sales, double click on that, and divided by 12. Okay, whatever I am want to do, I can, any mathematical calculation I can do. So sales should be divided by 12 and field should be like average. I will click add. Here you can see average here, then OK. So you can find the average also here, and here you can also see. Okay, you can set the number formatting also from here, value field setting, and there is a number format. You can choose the number format, like it should be shown as currency. Okay, so it is like currency, then it should be also in currency. But 0 digit. Like this, you can use the number format, custom formats also here. Okay. So you can do it from here. Then we have, after calculated field, we have calculated item also. It is like grouping. Let's suppose we have a team leader for three of them, Mahesh, Sujit and Abhishek, named Vijay. So we will have calculated item. Okay. We need to ungroup these all, this all before, because we have grouping here. So after removing grouping, we have this calculated item. In calculated item, we can make a group like Vijay will be equal to Mahesh plus Sujit plus Abhishek sales, because it's a team leader. We press add. Okay, so you can see the Vijay sales here. But when you are doing this, you should disable the extra data from here, because it will present you wrong data here by summing this value. So Mahesh, Sujit and Abhishek, now you have actual data. What type of formula and list you have used here? You have this list formula option. So in calculated field, whatever formula you have used, in calculated item, whatever formula you use, it will be displayed in separate sheet. Now you want to remove this. Go to solve order. Here you have calculated item, you can delete from here. Then for calculated field, this is the average. Oh, you can choose the average from here and delete. Okay, you can make your previous data. So calculated field and calculated item, you have some designs here available here. Based on that design, you can format your pivot table data. Okay. Band rows, band one. Band rows, insert a separate darker line in that. So you have design here, then almost everything we have covered in that. Let's see one more thing we can do with it. So I had told you that we can set value in value field setting. It is the name which is displayed here. And if you want to change the name, you can change, but it should not be equal to this field name. So you can use a space or underscore there, so it will be displayed here. Okay. And there are show value as. In show values as, in normal it is showing you like this, normal sum of sales. Difference from, in difference from, you can choose the difference from Sandeep. For any particular person, we can choose that the other person as creating how much difference. So Sandeep is on 0, he is plus 376, he is plus 165 to this value. So like this we can differentiate the value. We have separate reporting formats here. And then percentage of means how much percentage it is different. So Sandeep has 100% sales, then it is 105%. You can checking the percentage difference. So if it is 100%, it is 105%. Like this, we have separate percentage for everybody. We can target a particular person. Then percentage difference from Sandeep. So what is the percentage difference? It is 100%, it is 5% more, it is 1% down. Like this, we can get the report. Then we have running total in. Running total, this was 6,000 and total of these two, it is 13 and it is coming to grand total 34,000. Like this, running total. We can use this in running total in our financial report. Till quarter one we have this much revenue, till next quarter two we have this much revenue, like this. Percentage of row, percentage of column. This can be used when we have row here, row and column. So I insert city here. So percentage of row can be seen here. Percentage of row. So while it is 100%, what is the percentage containing these cities? Okay. Then percentage of column is the same. But it is for column. If this one is 100%, how much percentage it is containing? Okay. Like Sandeep have 19.69% contribution in total sales. Then you have percentage of total. So each field will be calculated individually according to the sales. So this is the 100% sales and the city is contributing this much percentage, person is contributing this much percentage in total sales. In total sales, Palwal city and Sandeep has this much contribution of total sales. So we have different type of criteria here, which we can practice, okay, for report generation. Now let's know about that, how to get the data from different sheet without opening an other file, how to take the data from other sheets. Before that, I tell you one concept more. Let's suppose we have a pivot table here. Name, city, sales. So we have a pivot table here. Now I am increasing this unit. 42,500. Now when I am pressing OK, it is shown here. Okay, but when I add something new, DJ, city Delhi, 29. I have added a new data here, but let's see when we press refresh, it is there or not. Not there. Why? Because we have a button here, change data source. We can we have what range we have selected, it was logged. Okay, So it is E668. So what is E668? Let me show you. So E668 is till this data. So in between you do changes, so it will be refreshed. But after that, if you do, you have to change the data source and select the data again from change data source. Like this, you have to select old data. But this thing, if you don't want to do every time, what you can do, let me delete just that data. This one also. What we can do, just select the data and do format as table or press Ctrl T. When you do format as table, my table data has headers, okay. So all the data is converted in table now. And here you have table tool, in design you have table name. So I give a name to this table data. So now this table has a name. It is a particular table or range. So what we have to do in change data source, just give the name of that. We have option table and range. So this is a table which we have given the name, and range means A1 to B2, like this. So when we have given the table name here, so table increases automatically. It is property. So when we are typing new data, so it increases the range. Okay. So when we refresh, we don't need to all the time do anything. Just press refresh and there.
So the key is just to change it as a table.
Yes. Just change it at a table. So when you add the data, just you have to do a refresh. You can see the refresh. Okay. If it is not picking there, so what is there? There is a small point here. You can see this one. So this is the basically table range. So you can increase the decrease table range. If you have selected till then, and if you refresh, it will show you this much of data only. Okay. So this is basically a table range which increase automatically. When you type anything down, so it increase automatically. Okay. So this is the magic about range only. Table increases its range automatically.
Now, would this work with dynamic data?
Yes. This is dynamic data changes within Excel, but from other sources we also take data, like from Access, SQL. So, how we do it? Let me show you. Let me delete this. So we have this data in this table only. Just close it. By the name of pivot data. It is not showing me exit option. There is something wrong. Just hang, I guess. Let me close it. we have this private data file here. Okay. We are opening a new Excel. Without opening file, we can access their data also. So if you want to take pivot from there, so in data, we have option, connection options here. From Access, from web, from text, from other sources. From other sources, from data connection wizard, other advanced for Excel, because we are accessing Excel only. You have to choose the file. No, not in this. Just make connection here. Add. In add, you have this much. Browse for more. And where you have saved the file, in desktop, Excel shortcut, pivot data, this one. So in available sheets, it will be shown to here. Just press OK. So it is added here. Close. So in existing connection, you can see this connection. Open. So this data for import data is here. So you can get the same data by table, pivot table report if you want. So you can click on pivot table. Okay. So you can get the whole data, or if you want to create pivot table, you can choose pivot table report. Press OK. So those fields will be available here. You can just apply from here. Okay. Without opening other file, you can create a connection. Okay.
Okay.
In this one file, you can create lot of connections from different files. Because if you are using a heavy data, which is impossible to build in one sheet, you can do it like this. Without opening that file, your Excel will not hang, because you are not importing all the data there. So it is, whatever changes will be there, you just refresh and it will be refreshed here. Suppose that file you have given to another person or shared somewhere, he is changing and you are just doing refresh. Okay.
Yeah, this is pretty cool stuff. This is perfect for the stock market, because we go through a lot of data.
Yes.
And so I will play around with the pivot tables.
And one more thing in connections. If you want to, if you go in existing connection, so there are some more things available. MSN money control, stock quotes, currency rates. These are connections as given by default by Excel. So you can take the money central investor currency rates, by means dollar to rupee, rupee to everything. But doing this, but there is some I guess error. That's why it is not showing. From other sources, from analysis, it's not analysis service, from data connection wizard, not from here. So there are basically lot of options you can use for data connection. From web, you can get the data. If you have some data on the web, just type the address there like but it should be normal HTML data. Dynamic data it is unable to get. A sky table. A sky table dot. Let me just see if it is plain data or not. It is just a picture. We can select this data. So we need plain HTML data. In basic sites, we can get it. There are actually no. This is not the basic site. So from web. Google. It is a basically a web browser. So these are yellow mark. Which you click, the data will be imported from that. So basic HTML data.
Yeah, I tried it before.
So this yellow mark you need to click on and you can get the related data from there. But today, nowadays there is not really that basic data available. Well, let's people use intranet and there they share data when they share data. So okay, forget about that. I will make you clear all these things in next session. The pivot table is about this much only. Okay, so next week.
Okay, thank you.
We will discuss power pivot and more data options in next session.